district as they fall to 8-7.
Does Dwyane Wade, does LeBron James, does Chris Bosh and the rest of the players want Eric Spoelstra out? No, but they are frustrated.
Fist up, go ahead.
These guys are here for a reason. We all want the same goal. And it's my job as head coach to push, to prod, to teach.
Just do your job, be reliable. Let go of your ego.
I spoke to Eric about how you're going to have to deal with the LeBron Jameses and the Dwyane Wades and the Chris Boshes of the world. And the only thing I ever said to him, I wasn't worried about whether or not, you know, he could deal with him, is that just go coach him. Just coach him.
We got to get tougher down there. It's two offensive rebounds. Those are in traffic. We can't give those up.
To be a real championship team, there has to be a healthy conflict. There has to be some kind of adversity where it's not always good, or where you can learn some kind of lesson and move forward.
Okay, easy run. Come on, let's get loose. Let's have a good one.
One thing about Coach Spo is what you see is what you get. He hasn't changed from the first day of training camp. And I think for this team, that was a constant good thing for us.
It's going to stop right here. Sharp with our pick and rolls.
Wade with a steal, gets it back from LeBron, and puts it in.
The Heat is starting to find a rhythm.
What I see now are talent bursts. All of a sudden, you know, Dwyane get 20 points in a quarter, you know, then the game's over. And then all of a sudden, LeBron get 19 in a quarter, and the game's over. And then Chris to take over. And so those are great. But what we need is to get those talent bursts to really meld into a team burst. And we're not there yet, but it's on its way. It's coming.
The Heat stunning this crowd and winning for the 12th straight game.
We've been through the ups, we've been through the downs. That's where you really bond and gain real trust, particularly when you're able to survive the lows that we have.
For the first time last season, the game ended in what can only be described as dramatic fashion.
Just looking, gets it to Bryant. Bryant dribbling, has to put it up with the buzzer. Banks it in! Ha-ha! He banks in the three!
It was the beginning of a memorable season for Kobe Bryant and the Lakers, which ended in a second straight NBA championship. The Heat, while they did make the playoffs, suffered an unceremonious first-round exit at the hands of the eventual Eastern Conference champion, Boston Celtics. In the offseason, Miami pulled off three of the biggest free agent signings in history, landing a trio of superstars unlike any other. On Christmas Day, the new-look Heat, led by LeBron James, Dwyane Wade, and Chris Bosh, head to Staples Center for the first and only time this year to take on Kobe Bryant, Pau Gasol, and the rest of the reigning NBA champions in an East meets West battle of epic proportions.
We're having fun now. We're about to.
Bryant trying to swat it away from behind. Wade kicks it out of the box.
Chris Bosh emphatically with the dunk and a chance for a three-point play.
Well,
Wade in the air on Bryant. He plays it down. Here comes Kobe. Wade back to the side. Wade chased by Fisher. Finds Jordan. LeBron shaken up as the Lakers call for time. Dwyane Wade with the steal. Miami takes a two-point lead.
When Wade gets this deflection right there, LeBron James is about 4 yards behind him. Instead, James winds up with the finish.
Seconds. Here's James to the rim. Oh. It counts and the foul. LeBron
shot clock to work with. Arroyo to the paint.
Wade, what a play!
How far did he reach to put that one back in?
We haven't seen that one yet. Dunking it from like about 5 feet out. That was something.
That was incredible.
Oh, Wade, what a play!
Wow.
Oh, wow! I need to see that again because I don't believe what he did.
Well, watch the extension of the body. How about that? Now, that's over a shot clock. That was just a great, great move.
What is love? Baby, don't hurt me. Don't hurt me.